all. So today we will start the discussion from the same point. So before going to start the class, first I'm going to tell you how to install the ASA in GNS3. So before going further, let's see how it actually works. So what you have to do is first you have to go to edit. Then you are going to click on preferences. Then the next step that you are going to do is you are going to click on QEMU. In QEMU, you will get the option of ASA. So from here, you are going to install the ASA. Then the next thing that you are going to do is you are going to define an identifier. So the identifier, you can give it any name. I'm giving ASA 9.x, any kind of name. It's up to you what name actually you want to define. Then he's asking about Android and kernel. So select it. So you need to have the Android and kernel. So this is Android, then kernel. So we will go back over there again. And kernel. This is the stuff. The last option that you have to do is you have to fill this QEMU option. So here what you are going to say is you are going to say no dash quit. So this is the command that you have to type. So what exactly you have to do is you have to perform four steps. So what are those steps? The first step is to define the name. Any kind of name, it's up to you. It's more like a locally significant value. It doesn't matter what type of name you are going to define it. Then this QEMU option. So this needs to be this one. Dash no dash quit without any space. Then you have to define the path for the intrade. And then you have to define the path for the kernel. So when you are going to access the file, you will get the option that this file is a intrade file and this file is a kernel file. So I can say that, okay, this is an intrade file. So as soon as you are going to see that image, you will get both the files, like this is intrade, this is kernel. And then the last step that you are going to do is you are going to say the save. I will not save it because I have already. So there is no sense of saving it, and just click on save and then press OK. Once you will do that, you will get the option of ASA firewall. If you will drag it and click on start, you'll get this QEMU. So don't close it, don't type anything, just minimize it. It will remain open until and unless you are going to access the firewall. So it will not affect anything, just minimize it. And double click on the ASA. And you will get this option. So here you have to select one of them. So always choose number 3. And then press enter. And you will get the access of the firewall. This is how it actually works. So just for a quick revision, I will let you know, go to the edit, preferences, QEMU, ASA, four fields, any logical name, dash no dash quit, intrade file, kernel file, click on save and then press OK. So this is how it actually works. So it's quite easy to install it, but guys, the iOS that you're going to install is 8.0. There are some commands, around 60% of the command will remain same, either you are using 8.0 or 9.x. There are some command that has been changed, and there are some new feature that has been introduced. So what we are going to do is the commands that are same, we are going to use on 8.0. It doesn't matter you are using 9.x or 8.x, it will remain same, just like assigning a default route, assigning the IP address, everything, all this stuff will remain same. Either you are using any kind of stuff like 8.x or 9.x. So 8.x, 9.x. The command will remain same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate some practical on 8.x, and there are certain practicals that can only and only performed on 9.x. So I will use 9.x on that time. But there are some common commands that can be typed over this thing also, or in this thing also, that will be same. So let's start the session without wasting any time. Okay, so what I'm going to, I'm going to share it. I'm not going to tell you that, okay, you have to download from this site. Whenever I'm going to share the video, I'm going to share the image of the ASA also. Don't worry about it. Now, so today, yesterday we talked about the ASA. Today we are going to compare the firewall with the router. This is router. This is ASA. So what are the commands that are different on the firewall? We will always use a router as our reference point that, okay, on this router, we used to type this thing, but on the ASA, the command has been changed. So we will use the firewall, we will use the router as our reference point. That on the router, how to define the host name? This is how we used to define the host name on the router. What's new in the firewall? This is how you will define the host name on the firewall. How to define the clock? This is how we used to define the clock on the router. So we will use the router as our reference point. Now, the first thing first, as soon as you are going to boot up, you are going to land in this mode. Guys, what do you mean by this mode? What is the name of this mode? Guys, what is the name of this mode? Exec, correct. So this mode is called exec mode. Same mode that we have on the firewall also. As soon as you are going to finish up the boot up, you are going to land on the exec mode of the ASA. Just like a router. So if I want to go to from exec mode to privilege mode, what command do we need to type? If I want to go to exec mode to privilege mode is this mode. What command do we need to type on the router? Enable, exactly, correct. So we have to type the command enable. So on the router, we used to say enable, and then we will go to the privilege exec mode. Same on the firewall, we have to type the enable, but there is a catch point. There is a point over here. As soon as you are going to type the enable, it will ask for a password because it is a security appliance. Tell me the password. Guys, there is no password by default. You have to do what? You have to press the enter. There is no password. And now you are going to land on the exec mode. So this is the key point. Don't type any kind of Cisco, CCIE, CCNA, anything. Don't type any kind of keyword. As soon as he will ask for the password, always press enter. Press enter. Because by default, there is no password. So by default, there is no password. So just press enter. Now, so we are going to land in the privilege mode. So the same here, we have the privilege mode. So now, guys, what is the show command to find out the IP address? Yeah, just enter. Guys, what is the command on the router to find out the IP of the interfaces? Show IP interface brief. Exactly, correct. So what we used to type is show IP interface brief. This is the command we used to type. I want to show you something, guys. Let's take a router. So the command is show IP interface brief. Guys, there is something wrong with this command. What do you mean by there is something wrong? See, I'm saying show IP interface brief. I want to see the IP of what interfaces. But technically, it is showing me first interfaces, then it is showing me what? IP address. As you can see from the show command, first I'm saying I want to see the IP, but technically it is showing me first interface. The command should be show interface IP brief, right? Not show IP interface brief. Why? Because the first keyword is IP, it needs to be show me first IP addresses. Then the next keyword is interface, then it needs to be show me the interfaces. So what this thing is, that always remember that show IP interface brief is showing me first interface, then it is showing me the IP address. But on the firewall, we used to type this thing by show interface IP brief. This is how we used to type. This is how we are going to type it. There is something change in it. So guys, always focus on this thing. On the ASA, we used to type show interface IP brief, which is technically a logical command. Show me the interfaces and their IP. Exactly, because the output is something like this one. Show me the interface and the IP. So this is how you will type, see the interfaces. Now, the next command is some, there are more show commands that most of them are same, exactly same. So 99% of the commands are same, like show clock. So in the privilege exec mode, you can type show clock. So there are lots and lots of show commands over there, show protocol. Yeah, so there is a command show run. Same, we have the command over here, show run. So almost all the show commands are same. There are one or two commands that are different. I will let you know what are those commands and what is the main difference in between those commands if I will compare it with the router. Now, if I want to go to the configure mode, what we used to type is configure terminal. Same on the firewall, we have to type configure terminal. As soon as you are going to type the configure terminal, you are going to directly land in the configure mode. This mode. This mode is called configure mode. Same. Guys, if I want to type, say for example, a show command over here, what is the command? If I want to type any of the show command, what extra stuff that I need to do? Suppose I want to type show IP interface brief, it will not work. What exactly I have to do? Do show, right? Exactly. So what I have to say is do show IP interface brief. And I will get the output for the clock. Do show clock. But guys, always remember this thing. So I have to say do show clock. Always remember this thing. ASA note. ASA does not support do command. You cannot type the keyword do. So ASA does not support do command. So this means what if we want to type show clock or show run on the configure mode, you can directly type that thing. You can say config show clock or show IP interface brief. So here we will type show interface IP brief. You don't need to worry about do and all that thing. So on the ASA, never ever use the do command. It is not supported. So you don't need to worry about that thing. Now, let me tell you, in case of zone-based firewall, let's start with the concept of this thing. The whole concept was started with the reflexive. That in the reflexive, what we did is we took three routers. Now, what we did is we said whenever the traffic will go out, note down the information. Note down the information. When the return traffic will come, evaluate that information, because we used to type the keyword evaluate. Evaluate the information. If it is not matched with the database, drop that packet. So these are the action that we use to define. So then we upgrade ourselves to CBAC. In the CBAC also, we use the same concept. That when the traffic is going out, note down the information. When the return traffic will come, match that information. Then in the zone-based firewall also, we did the same technology. Like yesterday, we did the same technology. What we said is note down the information when the traffic is going from source sales and when the destination is ISP. So I have defined a condition that note down the information only when the source is sales and the destination is ISP. And how to say the source is sale? We went to the interface and said zone member security sales. Zone member security ISP. So we said one thing that on the router that when the traffic is going from F0/0, to F0/1. So we said that when the traffic is going from F0/0 to F0/1, note down the information. Because we said source is sales, the destination is ISP. So when the traffic is going from F0/0 to F0/1, note down the information. Now the question is how this firewall works. This is the concept of reflexive and zone-based firewall. How actually ASA work in these kinds of stuff? Do we need to create zone? No, we don't need to create any kind of zone. So how the ASA is going to work? So for example, this is PC. This is the same server that we have. This is ASA. PC server. Now, how the traffic, how I'm going to say the firewall that, okay, note down the information when the traffic is going from PC to server. What I want to achieve is, I want to achieve note down the information when the traffic is going from PC to ASC. This is what I want to achieve. So that PC can access, not from PC to ASC, PC to server. So that PC can access the server, but server cannot access the PC. So if the traffic is initiated from the server, the ASA should drop the packet. The PC can access the server and can come back in, but if the traffic is initiated from the server, the traffic is dropped. It should be dropped. So if traffic is initiated from the server, the packet should be dropped because this is our ISP server. I don't want that Facebook is accessing my laptop. All I want is I can access the Facebook. I can retrieve my details like, okay, this is my timeline, this is my messages and everything. But I don't want that the Facebook is accessing my PC. I want I can access Google. I can access Yahoo. I can access Facebook. I can access YouTube. But I don't want that the YouTube, Facebook, Google, Yahoo is accessing my PC. I don't want that the traffic is should, if the traffic is initiated from the server, can access my PC. I don't want that. So this is how it works. So what we are going to do is we are going to use the concept of security level. Security level. What do you mean by security level? Security level means security level is a number from 0 to 100. So it is a number from 0 to 100. What is the behavior of the security level? Basically, Higher the number, more it is trusted. Lower the number, less it is trusted. So suppose I'm saying number 50 and number 40. So number 50 is higher, so I will say this is more trusted. This is 40, so this is a less number, so I will say less trusted. Okay, but we got this point that okay, security level is just a number from 0 to 100, where 0 means, sorry, higher number means more trusted and lower means less trusted. But what is the benefit of it? Because what we want is, we want to achieve this behavior that PC can access the server, but a server cannot access the PC. How can we do that? Basically, what we are going to do is, we are going to use the concept of security level, this number. How? The behavior of the appliance is, PC, server, ASA. This one. Now, what we are going to do is, we are going to assign the security level a number. Security level, a number from 0 to 100. Higher the number, more it is trusted. So this is my trusted network. Trusted network. And this is non-trusted network. And in between we have our ASA. Now, what we are going to do is, we are going to assign a number, suppose let's say 55. So this is our trusted network. With this security level of 55, I have to define a less trusted number, let's say 10. So this means a user from higher trusted network can access a user in a lower trusted network. A user from higher trusted network can access a user in a lower trusted network. How can I say which is higher or lower? Higher trusted network means higher security level. Lower trusted network means lower security level. So what I did is, I have defined the security level of 55, and here I have defined the security level of 10. So what the firewall saying, what the firewall is going to say is, whenever he will receive the packet, he will ask it, okay, I have received the packet on which security level? 55. Where you want to go? I want to go to security level 10. Okay, so this means you want to go from higher security level to a lower security level. So by default, higher security level to lower security level is allowed. higher security level to a lower security level is allowed. But if you will initiate anything from lower security level to a higher security level, it will be dropped. So if a user is sitting at higher security level, he can access all the lower security levels. But a user who is sitting at lower security level cannot access a user who is sitting at higher security level. So for example, let me demonstrate it more way. Like this is my PSA. This is router 1, this is router 2, and this is router 3. Okay. R1, R2, R3. So suppose the security level is here 66, 55, 44. So these are the security level that we have. So this means who can access whom? R1 will able to access, because R1 is higher, 66 can access R3 and R1 can access R2. Why? Because R1 is at higher security level 66, and he can access all the lower security level. Plus R3 can access R2 also, because R3 security level is 55 and R2 security level is 44. So I will say this is 66, this is 66, this is 55. And the R3 is 55, R2 is 44, and R2 is 44. So a user, this traffic is allowed. You don't need to worry about it. You have just need to define the security level. So just define a number from 0 to 100, any number. You can say 0, you can say 100. It's up to you which number you want to define. But always remember, a user at a higher security level can access the user at lower security level. So if you will say, so guys, okay, just wait on 1 second. Let me give you exercise. I want to ask you guys, what happened if this is my ASA? I have 4 routers, R1, R2, R3, R4. Let me ask you guys how it actually works. R3. R4. So I want you to draw the same topology, the diagram that I have, like this thing. So I want you, don't note down the security level, just write down this thing that okay, R1 can access R2, something like this one. Let me know who can access whom in this topology. I have configured it over here. So security level, let's say 100, security level 60, security level 40, security level 0. Okay guys, now let me know who can access whom. Just make something like this one. Just note down R1 can access R2. So note down the list, create a list who can access whom to find out that okay, are you getting it or not. There is a question, by default, all types of traffics are allowed, or any specific, all that, any type of traffic, any kind of IP traffic is allowed from a higher security level to a lower security level. R1 can access R2, R3, R4. No guys, what about R2? R2 can access R3, R4 or something like this one. So I will wait to see whether you are getting it or not. Okay. Yes, amazing guys. All of you are correct. R1 should able to access R2. R1 should able to access R2, R3, and R4. R2 should able to access R3 and R4. R3 will be able to access only R4, and R4 will not able to access any of the guys, because why? R4 has the lowest security level. Now, there is something, some exceptions are always there. What if, because some guys used to ask this question, that what if this is two routers, in between we have ASA. And the security level that we have defined is 50. And on this interface also, I have defined the same security level 50. Now both will have the same security level. This is the stuff that we have the same security level on both the devices. So ASA means for R1, 50, R2 is 50. Now, will they communicate or not? So guys, always remember, by default, they will not communicate. They will not communicate. You will not able to access from R1 to R2. So by default, R1 will not able to access R2. There is some commands that you need to type to allow the communication that we will talk about in CCNP security. But yes, they will not communicate by default. Cisco recommend this is a bad design. Now, why it is bad design? See, the level of the trust for both the devices is same. Because security level means what? Trust. How much you have trust. So if your trust is same, why don't you use this topology like this one? R1, R2, they are connected to a switch. And then connected to the ASA. Because you have same level of trust, that's why you have given the same number. So ASA, R1, R2, switch. If you trust both the devices equally, why don't you make like this type of topology and assign a security level of 50? Why you're using one extra interface of ASA? There is no sense of it. So this is how the design should work. But yes, there are exceptions, maybe in the exam also. They can provide you a troubleshoot where the security level of the firewall is same. And they are asking you that the communication is not working from this user to another user. Go to the firewall, check it. If security level is same, then you have to type the command that we will talk about in CCNP. Guys, I want to ask you something. Like, we have two approach for this training. I want you to let me know what approach do you want to follow. We have approach of to cover the topic something like this one. Like first, this is approach one. First cover CCNA security, then go to CCNP security, then go to CCI security. This is approach number one. The approach number two is something like this one. Focus on the technology, cover ASA, cover the firewall from the perspective of CCNA plus NP plus IE. Then take the VPN. In CCNA we have site to site NSSL, in CCNP we have DM and get VPN, in IE we have flex VPN. So take the VPN, finish it up from CCNA plus NP plus IE. Same like WSA, take it. In the CCNA we have an introduction, in NP we have some deployment, in IE we have some advanced scenarios. So guys, I want to ask you, which approach do you want to follow? This is a good approach. Like, take one box, finish it up to CCI level or discuss all the aspects, all the scenarios. This is a time consuming approach because I will cover the firewall, I will leave it in middle, then I will go back to another VPN, then finish it up. Then after a few weeks, I will start the class again for CCNP. Then I will say, okay, in CCNA, you have revised this thing, you have revised that thing, something like this one. So I want you to comment A1 or A2, which approach you want to follow. So I will go with the majority. If the majority is going to say A1, I will go with A1. A2 will say, I will go with A2. Basically, in A1, it will take 6 to 7 months to finish it up. In A2, it will take 5 months to finish up. But here you will get a device specific training, more like first ASA. So for the next 1 to 2 months, we will talk about only on the firewall. Every day we will talk about ASA. So then for the next 2 months, we will talk about VPN, something like this one. So it's a technology based approach. We are focusing only on the technology. Okay, so most of the guys is saying me about A2. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 students. 5 students who are saying A2, and there are 2 students who are saying A1. So I think majority wants A2. So what we are going to do is we are going to follow the A2 approach. So can we apply a job on a technology based? See, basically in the market. So right now also I'm looking for a job. So on the market basis, what they are looking is they are looking for the security perspective. They will ask you ASA, VPN. The main objective of the interviewer is going to ask you about ASA and VPN. If you will follow a approach of CCNA security, you will learn 5% of the ASA. Then you have to cover CCNP security. In CCNP security, you will learn 40% of the ASA. Then in CCI security, then you will learn the rest, which is 55% of the ASA. So technically, you have to wait for the next 6 months to finish up your complete ASA. But in the technology-based approach, you will finish up the ASA for the next 1 month or 1.2 months. Most of the interviewer is going to ask you about the firewall and the VPN. This is what they want. That's it. They want you to know the firewall VPN. WSA is more like the optional approach that they will ask you. WSA, Firepower. Firepower is something new. ICE, WLC, ACS. These are the 2 technologies which will help you to grab the job. So these are the 2 technologies that will help you to grab the job. Firewall, VPN. This is the technology that will help you to understand the scenarios in the production environment, like WSA, because 99% of the company used to do the URL filtering and everything. Doesn't matter whether they are doing it for the WSA or the for anything, but yes, they used a web security appliance. It doesn't matter if it is a Cisco device or it is some different vendor device. So this will help you to understand the URL filtering. This will help you to understand the device filtering. Like, I want you to make sure that whenever a user will connect a Dell laptop, then only I want to allow him inside my network. So that will be done through ICE. WLC will help you to understand how to deploy a SSID in a large network, like a really huge network. ACS is for device authentication. We have gone through ACS, but there are some advanced scenarios that are left. So this one. What about, okay. So we can apply the job on the technology base. Yes, so we or you always focus on the ASA and the VPN section, but yes, you need to have a good idea about all these technologies also, like WSA, Firepower, ICE, WLC, and ACS. So let's talk about how to initialize the interface. So for example, this is a router, this is a ASC. On the router, to initialize the interface, we go to the interface, we will say no shutdown, IP address. This is what we used to do it on the interface. No shut, IP, exit. These are the minimum command that we need to. So will we cover the IPS, cover Firepower in detail? Exactly, why not? We will focus the official syllabus also. So yeah, we will cover the Firepower in detail with all the practicals. And I gave my Firepower exam also. So basically I am Firepower certified also. There is two exams of Firepower, which is 500-280 and 500-285. Those are source fire certifications. Yeah, so we will talk about that also. So don't worry about it. Now on the ASA, always remember we can have two types of interface. Either your interface can be Ethernet, which is E0x0, which is Ethernet, or it can be a gigabit, which is G0x0. So there are only two categories of interfaces on the firewall. Initially, they were giving Ethernet. When fast Ethernet was not there in 1990s, when we don't have the concept of fast Ethernet, they were giving Ethernet. But as soon as they upgraded it themselves to the next generation firewall, they start giving gigabit. So if you will access a first generation firewall, you will see Ethernet E0x0, and if you will access next generation firewall, we have gigabit. Same in case of Firepower, when you will access the Firepower, you will see the gigabit interfaces. So now all the firewall technologies that we are using with next generation or the Firepower, we have gigabit. But when the first generation firewall was there, like PIX and ASA first generation, you will see Ethernet, but you will never ever see fast Ethernet. They directly shifted to the gigabit. Like in the router, they use Ethernet and they shift to fast Ethernet, and now the high-end series router shifted to gigabit. But ASA is the device that directly jumped from gigabit to from Ethernet to a gigabit. Okay, there is a question. Do you have lab setup for Firepower? Yes, I have it. I have a server that is at my home who is running a Firepower. So I have a dedicated server of 64 GB RAM where I used to practice for my exam, because in Feb I gave my exam of Firepower. So that time I purchased a server for the lab practices and UNL, in which I was using the Firepower topology. So yes, I have my own Firepower, because most of the time we used to deploy a virtual Firepower. 99% of the physical devices are virtual. Like ASAV, you can run it on the EXXI. ESA, email security appliance, or WSA, web security, all of them are virtualized. So you don't need to purchase a single physical box. So firepower is also virtualized. So yes, what we used to do is the topology that I'm going to make it for the firepower is something like this one, like PC, router, firepower, another router, and then it is connected to a ISP cloud. Something like this one. So this is how it works. So this is the firepower. I'm going to put it in between it. This kind of question you will get in your exam, like in, if you will go for a firepower certification, that you have to do it after your CCI because it is a specialized exam. So then you have to perform URL filtering that, okay, when this PC wants to access yahoo.com, I want him to redirect to google.com, like a redirection. When this PC wants to access yahoo.com or some malicious website, redirect automatically to them to google.com. So these kinds of stuff we will do it on the small topology. 99% of the practical can be performed only on these things. We can create a site-to-site VPN between router and the firepower. Something like this one. There is one more question. Let's see. Now, so basically the question is how to initialize the interface. So if we want to initialize the interface, what we are going to do is we will go to the interface gig zero, or if we have Ethernet, we will say interface E0/0. Then what we are going to do is we are going to say no shutdown. So no shutdown. Then I will say IP address, and then I'm going to assign the IP 12.1.255.255.255. So for now, let's make it gig 0/0. So this is what I will do it. So till now it's exactly same that we used to do it for the router, right? The next thing that I have to do is I have to define what? Guys, we were discussing something like few minutes ago, we were discussing some behavior of the firewall. What is that? We were discussing a packet flow, that a higher from a lower. What was that? How to define the trust of a network? Security level, exactly. So few moments ago we were discussing about what? Security level. So I will say a security level. Till now your interface is not initialized. It will not work. You cannot forward the packet. So you have to initialize the interface, and these are the minimum commands that you need to initialize the interface. It's not like this that you will go to the firewall, no shut it and assign IP and exit and done. No, it will not work at all. You need to define the security level because he needs to find out how much this interface is trusted. So security level and a number. So suppose the number is 60. So the last step, exactly, we have to define the name. So we will say name if. Now the question is, what is the scope of name if? Basically, we are defining a locally significant name to the interface, just like a zone. So in the firewall, in the router, when we were doing a zone based firewall, what we were doing is we were actually defining the name. like a zone. So it name something like this one. Zone security inside. And then we went to the interface and said zone member security inside. So from now on, what this interface name is inside. So this interface belongs to the inside. So here also we have to define a name to the interface. And from now onwards, you will not call interface gig zero. Suppose the name that I have defined is inside. So from now onwards, the name of this interface is inside. You will not call anything else about this interface. You will always call it inside. The name of the interface. When you will configure the ACL, you will not say I want to apply the ACL on gig 0x0. You will say I want to apply the ACL on interface inside. From now onwards, this interface name is inside. So this means if you want to do any kind of configuration, you will say I want to do the configuration on interface inside. I will let you know what is the real scope of NameIf as soon as we will start doing the configuration. I will tell you what is the actual scope of this thing, but this is the name that has been given to the interface so that in future, whenever we will do any kind of configuration and we have to call the interface, we will not call it gig 0x0. We will call it NameIf inside. So from now onwards, the name of the interface is inside. Now guys, there are certain exceptions. I will talk about in few moments. The exceptions are, if you are initializing the interface something like this one, gig 0x0, no shut, IP address 12.1.1, then if you will say first NameIf, so NameIf you are typing first before security level, and you said NameIf CCI. By default, as soon as you are going to define the NameIf, note the security level will be taken as zero. As soon as you are going to define the NameIf, the security level will be taken as zero. So the NameIf that you are going to define, any kind of NameIf that you are going to define, the security level will be taken as zero, except there is a condition. If the NameIf has been defined as inside, if you are defining the NameIf inside, the security level, basically inside keyword means trusted, the security level will be taken as 100. So guys, this is the most important point, that if you will define the NameIf without defining the security level, the security level will be taken as zero. So if I'm not specifying any kind of security level and I have defined just NameIf, so the security level will be zero. But if I will type the keyword inside, the security level will be taken as 100. This is the exception. You have to remember this thing. So NameIf, any kind of name, the security level is zero. If NameIf is inside, if the NameIf that I'm taking is inside, the security level is 100. So always say note, if NameIf is equal to inside, then security level is 100. If NameIf is anything else, any kind of NameIf that is left, ABC, XYZ, Cisco, Rahul, any kind of name that you are going to define, the security level will be zero. This is how it works. So guys, I want to ask you one quick question. Like if I'm saying interface big zero, no shut, name if CCIE, what will be the security level? If I'm specifying this name if as CCIE, what will be the security level? Zero, exactly. So the security level will be zero. I want you to, okay, let's see how many of you are getting this command. I want you to, in the exam also you will get this kind of configuration. Initialize the interface. Interface is gig 0x0. Security level should be 60. Name of the interface should be CCNA. And the IP address should be 15.1.1. And subnet mask should be /60. Guys, let me know how you are going to configure it. Let's see how much of you are getting it. I want you to initialize the interface something like this one. Debian, I think you have defined the wrong subnet mask, plus you haven't no-shut the interface. So there are two mistakes in it. What about rest of the guys? Okay, perfect. Okay, amazing. So this is how you are going to initialize the interface. Now, let's see guys. Okay, that's enough. So let's configure it on the GNS3. Let's see how it actually works. So let's create a small topology.
Let's take one firewall. So first we will not talk about the security level. First we will talk about some basic R1, R2 and AC, a small topology. 12.1.1, 12.2, 23.1, 23.2. Okay. Now. So interface at 0x0, no shut, IP address 12.0.1, so this is our firewall. So as we have discussed, this is our ASA and right now we are in the enable mode. So as we have to type the enable keyword, and guys, is what he's asking about the password. So I told you earlier, we don't have any kind of password. So what we have to do is we have to press enter. But always remember, if I will go back, if you will type some keyword like Cisco, it will not work. CCI, it will not work. So always remember, if this is a fresh router, just press enter. Sorry, fresh firewall, just press enter keyword. So this is the first step that you have to do. So by default, there is no password. So you don't need to type any kind of keyword. Just simply press the enter. The next thing that I told you about the interfaces. So on the router, the interface that we used to check is show IP interface brief. And this is what we get the output. Firewall should be in the middle. Right now, I don't want to explain the packet flow. Right now, I want to show you the basic initialization plus some static or default route. Once we are good with that, I'm going to put the firewall in between it. Then I will explain you how the packet is going through the devices. So right now I'm just playing with the routing part. Like if firewall wants to communicate R1, it will not able to do that by default. So how to assign a static route, how to assign a default route. So all that stuff. Now, so the command is show interface IP. This is the command that we will type. So yes, this is an Ethernet firewall. So this means this is a first generation firewall. So if I will put show version, this is 5520. This firewall is 5520. This firewall is currently holding a RAM of 128 GB of RAM. And this is the processor of the firewall. The size that he can store inside it is a 256 MB of flash. So inside it, you can store the iOS image, you can store the syslog messages, debug messages, whatever you want to store. These are the MAC addresses of each and every interface. So the output look like something this, show version. As soon as you are going to put the show version, you are going to see Cisco Adaptive Security Appliance software version is 8.0. So the version is 8.0. So this is not the actual output. So currently he does not have any kind of startup config, because we haven't saved any kind of config. He is not booted from any kind of TFTP server. So right now he has, because what we have an option is the firewall should be booted from a TFTP server. I don't want to host my image locally. I can download it from the TFTP or whatever. We will discuss about it this also, like how to upgrade the firewall, how to downgrade the firewall, something like this one. The ASA is up for the last 3 minutes, 8 seconds. Now you're going to see this timer should be increased 4 minutes, 46 seconds. And this is the hardware of the box. And these are the MAC addresses of each and every interface. I will talk about more in this stuff when we will talk about some advanced scenarios. But right now, let's focus on the basic stuff, how to assign the IP. So the command to check the interface is show interface IP brief. Now, configure terminal. So configure terminal. So this is the command that we are going to type. And now we will say interface Ethernet 0x0. No shut. If I will say IP address, let's say 23.2. So guys, right now I have defined IP address. So show history. But if it was a router, I have to say do show history. Then only the command will work. If I will say show history, it will not work. He will tell me, okay, you have to use the keyword do. Then only it will work. But here I don't need to type do keyword. So I will directly say show history. I will get the interface. I have no shut it, because by default all the interfaces are in the down state. Then what we have to do is we have to assign the IP address. Now, but if you will go to the interface, still you are not going to see any kind of IP. There is no IP address that has been assigned. Why? As you can see from the output, we have assigned it already. But when you will type show interface IP brief, you will not see any kind of IP address. Why? Because the interface is still not initialized. And the reason is security level and the name if. So let's define the name if. If I will say name if, any name CCIE. Guys, what should be the security level? If I will say name if CCIE, what should be the security level? Yes, true. So whenever I will define anything except from inside keyword, the security level should be zero. So now you will see that the security level for CCI set to zero by default. And now you will see the interface is initialized. Now you can see the IP on the interface. So these are the mandatory commands that you need to do. No shut, IP, security level, and the name if. So security level is automatically defined to zero. But in this command, I cannot see the security level. All I can see is the IP. Now the question is, how to find out what is the security level of this interface? If I want to check it, how can I say that the security level of E0x0 is 50, 60, 0? So the command to check the security level is show name if. So from this command, you will check the security level. So on E0x0, the name of the interface is CCI and the security level is 0. Now guys, let's configure one more interface just for revision perspective, just to see whether security level 100 is there or not. So no shut. If I will say name if inside, because I have already specified you that if you will say name if inside, that if your name if is inside, the security level will be taken as 100. This is already proof that whatever the name if that you will define, it will take security level as 0. If name if is inside, security level must be 100. So let's verify it. So if I said it name if inside, the security level was taken as 100. If you want to verify it, show name if. So E0 by 1, the security level is 100. So this is how you will do it. Now let's see. So this topology has been achieved. So this means R1 should be able to ping R2, ping 12.2. Yes, and R2 should be able to ping R1 and firewall. So ping 12.1, yes, and 23.2, yes. As you know that router needs some R packet. This is a CCNA RNS topic. I don't want to go inside it because as everybody is aware about this thing, that ARP is what? A binding of IP and MAC addresses. Same, firewall also maintain this concept and you can check it by show ARP. You can type this command in the this mode or in this mode, it's up to you. So it's maintaining that CCI interface name is CCI, show name if. So CCI stands for E0 by 0. Here he's telling me interface is what? F0 by 0. I told you when I was explaining you about name if that from now onwards you will not call it E0 by 0, you will call it CCIE. So as you can see it over here that E0 by 0 name is what? CCI. So it's telling me interface CCIE has been binded with the ARP of 23.1 where the MAC address of that IP is this thing. You can check it, this MAC address should be of this one. So this is this one. So 1D98001 and you will see 1D98001. So to check the ARP on the firewall, the command is show ARP, the same command that you were typing on the router. The only difference that we have is CCIE. So there it was showing me Ethernet E0 by 0. Here it is showing me CCIE. And from show name if I can check it that okay, CCI stands for E0 by 0. But there's a question, I'm using IS 8.0. Is it any difference if I will use 9.x? Let me demonstrate the same practical over 9.x, initialization of interfaces. So today we were focusing on how to initialize the interface. And I will show you, it doesn't matter which IS you will use. So let me run my UNL. So you can use UNL also, Unified Networking Labs. This is more like a advanced version of GNS3. Those who are not aware about it, this is the advanced version of GNS3 which can host any kind of stuff. You can make a complete CCI lab in it. If you have some good hardware like a 32 GB of RAM, you can simulate the whole RNS security or even CCN and CCNP data center lab in this thing. So let's define the password and let's take the GUI. So let's create a small topology. So let's start it. So this is a topology that I have it. I don't know what we have in this thing, but yes, we have a topology. So let's enable it. So this is also a ASA. So it's booting up. It will take some time to boot it up, but yes. Now guys, this is the firewall, which is the latest iOS image of the firewall right now. So if I will go to the enable show version, you will see the iOS that is it is running is 9.6, the latest one that we have. So yes, we will perform most of the practical over here. So last time what you have seen is the iOS that he was using is using 128 GB of RAM. But this iOS is using 2 GB of RAM. And the flash size is 8192 MB. And that there the flash size was really, really less. So this is a next generation firewall. This means the better output and throughput. So you can see from the hardware perspective, this has been upgraded. So it's running over 2 GB of RAM as compared to a first generation firewall, which is running over 128 MB of RAM. The compact flash size is also big. You can store multiple iOS image, or you can store any Connect VPN image. You can debug syslog, NetFlow, lots of stuff. You can save it over here. These are the MAC addresses. So same, you if you want to initialize the interface, show interface IP brief. So these are gigabit. As you can see, this is our next generation firewall image, which is the most latest one. So you will see we are using gigabit over here. So interface gig 0x0, no shut. If I will say name if inside, the security level should be 100. So it will set the security level to 100. And then IP address. IP address 12.1. Exit. That's it. Show interface IP brief. IP is there. So you don't need to worry about which iOS version you are practicing, because whenever there will be a difference in the iOS version, I will explain you that this command is different in this version or that version. So till now, whatever the command that we have discussed, those are completely same, either you are running 7.x, 8.x or 9.x. The behavior of the appliance is completely same. So which version you are running technically doesn't matter. So guys, any doubt up to this point, you can ask it. Okay, there's a question. Explain about the deployment of UNL in VM. Okay, it's quite easy actually. Let me explain you how it actually works or how to install it. So what you have to do is, so I have stopped it. So first you have to go to the Google, and first you have to download the image. That image is really easy. EveNG. So this one, click on download. And what it's up to you which you want to download. So I want to download a OVA from, let's download it from this one, not Mega Mail. So just click on it, they will start the download process. So soon you are going to see the image. So download, so save. And now your downloading is going to be start. Now Once the download has been finished, what you have to do is you have to go to the file, open, and open that IS image, whatever that has been downloaded. So I have already downloaded it. So you just go to the So you will get this one. So double click on it and just click on import. That's it. As soon as you are going to click on import, it will start importing it. Once the importing is going to be finished, you will get this kind of option. UNL. And then click on power on. That's it. This is how it's really easy. It's really, really easy to configure it. So click on power on, assign the IP and start using it. You don't need to worry about anything else. There's one amazing video. After that, how we can add the ASA image. So if you want to add different images, it's up to you which image you want to add it. So for that, you have to use a software. Let me go to YouTube. So this is their official YouTube channel. So here they are explaining it about the process, how it actually works. So how install UNL on the VMware workstation. So from here you can see everything. So he's explaining the same stuff that I have explained it. How to assign this thing, how to download the image, how to set up the IP. So even from my perspective, I have just watched this video and I have installed it. So this is the video from where you can load the images. So this guy is explaining me about it. So from here, I have loaded all the images. So I took the help of their official channel, which is EVNG, Emulated Virtual Environment. Just drag and drop the images. So something like this one. So I have used this stuff to install the images also. So just follow their official YouTube channel video. And from there, they will explain everything. Even I'm used to follow this thing. So it's quite easy to use it, but initial level, you will face some kind of problem, but hardly if you have to watch the YouTube channel in a better way, you'll get all the solutions. So guys, okay. So from tomorrow, we will start doing the practicals of firewall. So today we did the introduction. I will share the GNS3 image so that you can start practicing on the GNS3 about the initialization of the interfaces. So from tomorrow, I will start giving you some tasks also, some small labs that you have to do it by your own. Okay, guys, till then, if you have any doubt, you can ask it. See you guys. Bye-bye. Have a good day. Okay, which version of the GNS3 to be downloaded? Guys, I will always recommend to use 8.6 or 8.7. Use GNS3 0.8.7. This is really good. Use this one. So guys, we will see you tomorrow at the same time, 7 o'clock. Bye-bye guys. Have a good day.